Good morning, good morning, good morning, brothers and sisters. This is Prophet West coming back to you again at the school, waiting on to go in. Got a little time, little mama, she enjoying herself back in the back, watching her Peppa Pig or whatever her cartoons in her domain. And while she's in her domain, I'm in my domain. Good morning, I'd like to bless you and greet you in the name of the Lord. I want to talk about briefly, if I can, before the bell rings and before she gets upset or know it. I want to talk about anxiety. I want to talk about annoyance. I'm talking about a certain feeling that many of you get either when you get this feeling, either when there's some of you that something hadn't happened yet, but your mind is so into the future of something that could potentially happen, negative or positive, more so negative, that you are allowing what hadn't happened yet to destroy your enjoyment or your today. So in other words, don't allow tomorrow or what you think that's going to happen tomorrow destroy where you're living at today. And this is many of you, your mind is somewhere else that ain't happened. You getting upset. You going through all kind of emotions and doing all that, and ain't happen. And so I want to say to relax and to focus on what you have before you. The Bible says now faith is the substance of things. So for right now, deal with and face what you face today. The Bible even lets us know, boast not in yourself for tomorrow, because we don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. But better yet, Lord's will. And so God is going to take care of that. He's going to take care of your tomorrow, just like he's going to take care of your day. But it's important to you is to have a positive attitude. My spiritual father always said a spiritual attitude will affect your spiritual altitude. The situation might be bad, but your mindset toward it might determine or will determine how you deal with it, or how you go through your test, how you go through that situation. Because every situation, every test, every pain, every hurt, they all have an expiration date. They're going to die. They're going to end at some point. Every season has an expiration date. Every season, every day has an expiration date. So there's nothing that's permanent but living for Christ. Having everlasting life. If you accept the Lord as your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you live forever, eternity. So that's the only guaranteed thing. But another thing that some of you are annoyed by, you're so annoyed, you've given so much that you felt like people has taken advantage of you so much, the situation that take advantage of you so much. When someone asks you to do something, you get annoyed, you get attitude. You get that attitude when someone even asks you to do something, because you're so burnt out with giving. You're so burnt out with helping people. You're so burnt out with people. You're so burnt out. You're just tired. You're tired. And it's not that you don't want to give, but you just got to a place where you just need healing. You need repairing, restoration. You need all those things. But you're the type of person that you're at a place where you're so burnt out. You're burnt out with people. You're burnt out with people taking advantage of you. You're burnt out with family members always wanting something. You're burnt out with people always calling you or texting you and asking for something, but never asking how you're doing. And so, but I just want to encourage you to know that those are feelings. Those are anxieties. Those are moves. God wants you to deal with those things. God wants you to deal with those moves. God wants you to deal with those anxieties. And you deal with them by saying, God, help me. Help me in this situation. Help me with this shortcoming that I have. And he will. He said that ask it shall be given, seek and shall find, knocking it shall be open. And so that temperamental thing, that mood thing, that emotion thing, God wants to calm that down. The Bible lets us know you can be angry, but don't sin. Don't let the sun go down on your wrath. In other words, when you get angry, begin to think, process. Why are you angry? What is this passion? What is this energy? And prepare, well proportion that energy and that where it's supposed to go. If that energy needs to go in prayer, if that energy needs to go in helping someone, if that energy needs to go in fixing something, doing something with your hands, doing something, and counseling someone, if that energy needs to be put in being a testimony to help someone else that's going through something that you've been through, whatever it is, when you get these feelings, these emotions, don't react to those emotions, those feelings, but fight to process what God wants you to do and how he wants you to use this energy. Hope this makes sense. Y'all know you hear my background in the back. She enjoying herself. But we do what we do. We do what we do to get the gospel out, get the word out. Hope this word has been a blessing to you. Hope it's really touched you in so many ways. Thank you. God bless you and heaven smile on you. Chances are I will be back. But just remember, control your anxiety. Control your emotions. The Bible lets us know to be anxious for nothing. Don't be in a rush for nothing. But be patient. But with everything, with prayer, supplication, and with thanksgiving, make a request known unto God. But God wants us to pace ourselves. Pace ourselves. Don't push the cart before the horse. Everything has steps. Everything, there's guidelines. There's a system to everything. There's a system to being blessed. God said, if you walk upright before me, the afflictions that are laid upon the Egyptians, I will not lay them upon you. So there are steps and there are systems to cause God's power and cause God's blessings to come upon us. And that is obedience. Obedience is better than sacrifice. The day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. All those things, trust in the Lord and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path. There's a system. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all things will be added. Those are systems. And so when you do it God's way, the Bible also says, if you abide in me and my word is abide in you, you can act what you will and it shall be done. Those are systems. Whoso shall call on the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. That's a system. And so do what the system said. Do what God called you to do from the Bible. If you don't know, open the Bible up. Open the Bible up. Go through the index. Or even with Google, there's a certain question, an answer that you need to know or learn. Ask Google the question, and Google will give you the answer or will show you the reference to find it. You know, things are different now, not how it was when I was a kid. When I needed information, I had to go to the library. Had to do a whole lot of research, but now you hit certain keys. You can say certain things now. So that we are without excuse. We are without excuse. God said, my people perish for the lack of knowledge because they reject knowledge. Well, it's not without excuse now because knowledge is all around. You hear the key of knowledge to come up. And so educate yourself. Educate yourself on your condition. Educate yourself on what you want to happen, what you want God to do in your life. Educate yourself on God's system. You know, it's always important to learn. Knowledge is the principal thing. Wisdom is the principal thing. All you're getting an understanding. Knowledge is important because knowledge is information. You know, in the beginning, the tree of good and evil, that was information. Good and evil, the tree, that's information. That was good information, that was bad information. So information is learning. Information is a download. Information is God's word. When you open up God's word, that's information. And that is the very thing that you need. Just like when you go into a computer, you want to get into an app. You got to hit a certain thing to give it a certain information where to respond. You have to tell it certain things, put in the password, passcode, those are information. And that information will unlock or give you access. And that's all I'm trying to do. I'm trying to give you the information and tell you to use the information that unlock your blessing and that will give you access to God. God bless you. Have a good morning. God bless you.